Hello again, and welcome back to another Tooltip Tuesday. And today's tooltip will be with the iBalance software. So let's go into the applications and select iBalance. So you can see here there are two options. One is balance the grinding wheel, or you just want to watch the vibration monitor and understand what the imbalance of the grinding wheel is. So let's select the balance wheel software, which opens up a new window. And so as we all know, the iBalance software is a standard software that comes with all ANCA machines. And the core function is to balance the grinding wheels inside the machine, mounted on the spindle where it is going to be used at the required RPM, and also at the required direction of rotation. So this is very important. Now, traditionally, the balancing is done externally and then brought it into the machine. And there always have some mismatch between where it has been balanced and where it's going to be used. Commonly recommended method for balancing, it has to be done on the spindle in use, at the RPM and at the direction of rotation. So here we have the software, and on the left hand side is just a quick workflow on how the balancing occurs. There are a few key elements I want to bring up. So for the spindle RPM, the user is expected to enter a value. Considering the wheel shown here, it looks like a floating wheel, maybe a 1A1, say 150 diameter. So I'm going to choose the RPM, say 2600. And something to note here is that always use the RPM which the grinding wheel is going to be used while grinding, or much more higher, but never below that RPM. And then the C-axis position is the position where that particular grinding wheel is going to be used. So in this case, I might say minus 30 degrees. And the calibration weight will actually come in later once I start next. Now, another tip also to note here is if you go into the advanced section, there is also a few other parameters available here. But one thing specifically I want to make a note is that spin clockwise. By selecting that, you are now able to control the direction as well. Some key points to note. Number one, use the spindle RPM of use while grinding or higher, and plus the actual position of the C-axis where it's going to be used, and also going to the advanced section, and you are able to also control the direction. So the machine will have a default direction counterclockwise, and you can go and change to spin to clockwise as well if required. I hope you got something out of it, and I'll see you next time with another Tooltip Tuesday.